This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Solaris is a Unix operating system originally developed by Sun Microsystems. It superseded their earlier SunOS in 1993. Oracle Solaris, so named as of 2010, has been owned by Oracle Corporation since the Sun acquisition by Oracle in January 2010. Solaris is known for its scalability, especially on SPARC systems, and for originating many innovative features such as DTrace, ZFS, and Time Slider. Solaris supports SPARC-based and x86-based workstations and servers from Oracle and other vendors, with efforts underway to port to additional platforms. Solaris is registered as compliant with the Single Unix Specification. Historically, Solaris was developed as proprietary software in June 2005. Sun Microsystems released most of the codebase under the CDDL license, and founded the OpenSolaris open source project with OpenSolaris. Sun wanted to build a developer and user community around the software after the acquisition of Sun Microsystems in January 2010. Oracle decided to discontinue the OpenSolaris distribution and the development model in August 2010. Oracle discontinued providing public updates to the source code of the Solaris kernel, effectively turning Solaris 11 back into a closed-source proprietary operating system. Following that, in 2011 the Solaris 11 kernel source code leaked to BitTorrent. However, through the Oracle Technology Network OTN, industry partners can still gain access to the in-development Solaris source code. Source code for the open-source components of Solaris 11 is available for download from Oracle Contents 1 History 2 Supported Architectures 21 Other Platforms 3 Installation and Usage Options 4 Desktop Environments 5 License 51 Traditional Operating System License 1982-2004 52 Open Source 2005 until March 2010 53 Post Oracle Closed Source Solaris 10 after March 2010, and Solaris 11 2011 and later 6 Version History 7 Development Release 8 Open Source Derivatives 81 Current 82 Discontinued 9 See also 10 References 11 External links History in 1987, at businesses that would also use Solaris on their high-end server machines. It included the WABI emulator to support Windows applications for smaller clients. Sun simultaneously maintained the interactive Unix system that it had acquired from Interactive Systems Corporation. Supported architectures. Solaris uses a common code base for the platforms it supports, SPARC and i86%, which includes both x86 and x86-64. Solaris has a reputation for being well-suited to symmetric multiprocessing. Processing, supporting a large number of CPUs. It has historically been tightly integrated with Sun SPARC hardware, including support for 64-bit SPARC applications since Solaris 7, with which it is marketed as a combined package. This has led to more reliable systems, but at a cost premium compared to commodity PC hardware. However, it has supported x86 systems since Solaris 21 and 64-bit x86 applications since Solaris 10, allowing Sun to capitalize on the availability of commodity 64-bit CPUs based on the x86-64 architecture. Sun has heavily marketed Solaris for use with both its own x64 workstations and servers based on AMD Opteron and Intel Xeon processors, as well as x86 systems manufactured by companies such as Dell, Hewlett-Packard, and IBM. As of 2009, the following vendors support Solaris for their x86 server systems: Dell will test, certify, and optimize Solaris and OpenSolaris on its rack and blade servers and offer them as one of several choices in the overall Dell software menu. Intel Hewlett-Packard distributes and provides software technical support for Solaris on Proliant server and blade systems. Fujitsu Siemens as of July 2010, Dell and HP certify and resell Oracle Solaris, Oracle Enterprise Linux and Oracle VM on their respective x86 platforms, and IBM stopped direct support for Solaris on x64 kit. Other platforms. Solaris 251 included support for the PoRPC platform, PoRPC reference platform, but the port was cancelled before the Solaris 26 release in January 2006. A community of developers at Blastwave began work on a PoRPC port, which they named Polaris, in October 2006. An OpenSolaris community project based on the Blastwave efforts and Sun Labs project Pulsar, which re-integrated the relevant parts from Solaris 251 into OpenSolaris, announced its first official source code release. A port of Solaris to the Intel Itanium architecture was announced in 1997 but never brought to market. On November 28, 2007, IBM, Sun, and Sign nominee associates demonstrated a preview of OpenSolaris for System Z running on an IBM System Z mainframe under Z, VM, called Sirius in analogy to the Polaris project, and also due to the primary developer's Australian nationality, HMS Sirius of 1786 was a ship of the First Fleet to Australia on October 17, 2008. A prototype release of Sirius was made available, and on November 19 the same year, IBM authorized the use of Sirius on System Z integrated facility for Linux IFL processors. Solaris also supports the Linux platform application binary interface ABI, allowing Solaris to run native Linux binaries on x86 systems. This feature is called Solaris Containers for Linux Applications SCLA, based on the branded zones functionality introduced in Solaris 10.8.07 installation and usage options. Solaris can be installed from various pre-packaged software groups, ranging from a minimalistic reduced network support to a complete entire plus OEM installation of Solaris is not necessary for an individual to use the system. Additional software, like Apache, MySQL, etc., can be installed as well in a packaged form from Sunfreeware and OpenCSW. Solaris can be installed from physical media or a network for use on a desktop or server, or be used without installing on a desktop or server. Desktop environments OLVWM with OpenWindows on Solaris. Early releases of Solaris used OpenWindows as the standard desktop environment in Solaris 20. To 22, OpenWindows supported both news and X applications, and provided backward compatibility for SunView applications from Sun's older desktop environment. News allowed applications to be built in an object-oriented way using PostScript, a common printing language released in 1982. The X window system originated from MIT's Project Athena in 1984 and allowed for the display of an application to be disconnected from the machine where the application was running, separated by a network connection. Sun's original bundled SunView application suite was ported to X. Sun later dropped support for legacy SunView applications and news with OpenWindows 33, which shipped with Solaris 23, and switched to X11R5 with display PostScript support. The graphical look and feel remained based upon OpenLook. OpenWindows 362 was the last release under Solaris 8. The OpenLook Window Manager OLWM with other OpenLook specific applications were dropped in Solaris 9, but support libraries were still bundled, providing long-term binary backwards compatibility with existing applications. The OpenLook Virtual Window Manager OLVWM can still be downloaded for Solaris from Sunfreeware and works on releases as recent as Solaris 10. The Common Desktop Environment CDE was open-sourced in August 2012. This screenshot is a build of CDE for Linux. Sun and other Unix vendors created an industry alliance to standardize Unix desktops as a member of the Common Open Software Environment COSE initiative. Sun helped co-develop the Common Desktop Environment CDE. This was an initiative to create a standard Unix desktop environment. Each vendor contributed different components. Hewlett-Packard contributed the window manager, IBM provided the file manager, and Sun provided the email and calendar facilities as well as drag and drop support. Tooltalk. This new desktop environment was based upon the Motif look and feel, and the old OpenLook desktop environment was considered legacy CDE. Unified Unix desktops across multiple open system vendors. CDE was available as an unbundled add-on for Solaris 24 and 25, and was included in Solaris 26 through 10 in 2001. Sun issued a preview release of the open-source desktop environment GNOME 14, based on the GTK toolkit, for Solaris 8. Solaris 9.8.03 introduced GNOME 20 as an alternative to CDE. Solaris 10 includes Sun's Java desktop system JDS, which is based on GNOME and comes with a large set of applications, including StarOffice. Sun's Office Suite. Sun describes JDS as a major component of Solaris 10. The Java desktop system is not included in Solaris 11, which instead ships with a stock version of GNOME. Likewise, CDE applications are no longer included in Solaris 11, but many libraries remain for binary backwards compatibility. The open source desktop environments KDE and XFCE, along with numerous other window managers, also compile and run on recent versions of Solaris. Sun was investing in a new desktop environment called Project Looking Glass since 2003. The project has been inactive since late 2006. License traditional operating system license 1982-2004 for versions up to 2005 Solaris 9. Solaris was licensed under a license that permitted a customer to buy licenses in bulk, and install the software on any machine up to a maximum number. The key license grant was, license to use customer is granted a non-exclusive and non-transferable license for the use of the accompanying binary software in machine-readable form, together with accompanying documentation software, by the number of users and the class of computer hardware for which the corresponding fee has been paid. In addition, the license provided a license to develop, granting rights to create derivative works, restricted copying to only a single archival copy, disclaimer of warranties, and the like. The license varied only little through 2004. Open source 2005 until March 2010. From 2005 to 10, Sun began to release the source code for development builds of Solaris under the Common Development and Distribution License CDDL. Via the Open Solaris project. This code was based on the work being done for the post-Solaris 10 release code named Nevada, eventually released as Oracle Solaris 11 as the project progressed. It grew to encompass most of the necessary code to compile an entire release, with a few exceptions. Post-Oracle closed source Solaris 10 after March 2010, and Solaris 11 2011 and later when Sun was acquired by Oracle in 2010. The Open Solaris project was discontinued after the board became unhappy with Oracle's stance on the project in March 2010. The previously freely available Solaris 10 was placed under a restrictive license that limited the use, modification and redistribution of the operating system. The license allowed the user to download the operating system free of charge, through the Oracle Technology Network, and use it for a 90-day trial period. After that trial period had expired, the user would then have to purchase a support contract from Oracle to continue using the operating system. With the release of Solaris 11 in 2011, the license terms changed again. The new license allows Solaris 10 and Solaris 11 to be downloaded free of charge from the Oracle Technology Network and used without a support contract indefinitely. However, the license only expressly permits the user to use Solaris as a development platform and expressly forbids commercial and production use. Educational use is permitted in some circumstances from the OTN license. If you are an educational institution vested with the power to confer official high school, associate, bachelor, master and or doctorate degrees, or local equivalent, degrees, you may also use the programs as part of your educational curriculum for students enrolled in your degree programs solely as required for the conferral of such degree collectively educational. Use. When Solaris is used without a support contract, it can be upgraded to each new point release. However, a support contract is required for access to patches and updates that are released monthly. Version history. Solaris logo introduced with Solaris 10 and used until Oracle's acquisition of Sun. Notable features of Solaris include DTrace, Doors, Service Management Facility, Solaris Containers, Solaris Multiplexed I/O, Solaris Volume Manager, ZFS, and Solaris Trusted Extensions. Updates to Solaris version are periodically issued in the past. These were named after the month and year of their release, such as Solaris 10 and a 13th. As of Solaris 11, sequential update numbers are appended to the release name with a period, such as Oracle Solaris 113. In ascending order, the following versions of Solaris have been released, color meaning red release no longer supported green. Release still supported blue. Future release Solaris version SunOS version release date end of support. License form major new features SPARC-x86-1x41x1991-1994 September 2003 traditional license SunOS 4 rebranded as Solaris 1 for marketing purposes. See SunOS article for more. Information 2050 June 1992 to January 1999 traditional license preliminary release primarily available to developers only, support for only the Sun 4C architecture. First appearance of NIS 2151 December 1992 May 1993 April 1999 traditional license support for Sun 4 and Sun 4 meters architectures added, first Solaris x86 release, first Solaris 2 release to support SMP22. 52 May 1993 to May 1999 traditional license SPARC only release, first to support Sun 4D architecture, first to support multi-threading libraries UI threads API in libthread. 2353 November 1993 to June 2002 traditional license SPARC only release, open Windows 33 switches from news to display PostScript and drops SunView support. Support added for AutoFS and cache file systems. 2454 November 1994 September 2003 Traditional License First Unified SPARC, x86 release includes OSF, Motif Runtime Support 2555 November 1995 December 2003 Traditional License First to support UltraSPARC and include CDE, NFS v3 and NFS, TCP dropped Sun 4 vMebis support POSIX1 C1995P threads added doors added but undocumented 251,551 May 1996 September 2005 Traditional license the only Solaris release that supports PoRPC, Ultra Enterprise support added, user and group IDs UID_T, GID_T expanded to 32 bits, also included processor sets and early resource management technologies. 2656 July 1997 July 2006 Traditional license includes Kerberos 5 PAM, TrueType fonts, WebNFs, large file support, enhanced ProCFS SparkServer 600 MP series support dropped 757 November 1998 August 2008 Traditional license the first 64-bit UltraSPARC release added native support for file system metadata logging UFS logging dropped MCA support on x86 platform Sun dropped the prefix 2 in the Solaris version number, leaving Solaris 7. Last update was Solaris 7 and 1199/858 February 2000. March 2012 Traditional license includes Multipath I/O, Solstice Disk Suite, IPMP, first support for IPv6 and IPsec manual keying only, MDB modular debugger introduced role-based access control RBAC, Sun 4C support removed last update is Solaris 8.2.04.9.59 May 28, 2002 January 10, 2003 October 2014 Traditional license iPlanet directory server, resource manager, extended file attributes, IKE IPsec keying, and Linux compatibility added, open windows dropped, Sun 4D support removed most current update is Solaris 9905-HW-10-510 January 31, 2005 January 2021. Before Oracle acquisition in March 2010, open source under CDDL after March 2010, post-Oracle closed source includes x86 64 AMD 64, Intel 64 support, DTrace dynamic tracing, Solaris containers, Service Management Facility SMF which replaces INITD scripts, NFS v4 least privilege security model support for Sun 4 meters and UltraSPARC I processors removed support for ASA-based PCs removed adds Java desktop system based on GNOME as default desktop Solaris 10.1.06 known internally as U1 added the Grub bootloader for x86 systems, ISCSI initiator support and FC info command line tool Solaris 10.6.06 U2 added the ZFS file system Solaris 10.11.06 U3 added Solaris trusted extensions and logical domains Sun 4v Solaris 10.8.07 U4 added Samba Active Directory support, IP instances part of the OpenSolaris Network Virtualization and Resource Control Project, ISCSI target support and Solaris containers for Linux applications based on branded zones, enhanced version of the resource capping daemon RCAPD Solaris 10.5.08 U5 added CPU capping for Solaris containers, performance improvements, SpeedStep support for Intel processors and PowerNow, support for AMD processors Solaris 10.10.08 U6 added boot from ZFS and can use ZFS as its root file system Solaris. 10.10.08 also includes virtualization enhancements including the ability for a Solaris container to automatically update its environment when moved from one system to another, logical domains support for dynamically reconfigurable disk and network I/O, and paravirtualization support when Solaris 10 is used as a guest OS in Xen-based environments such as Sun X VM Server Solaris 10.5.09 U7 added performance and power management support for Intel Nehalem processors, container cloning using ZFS clone file systems, and performance enhancements for ZFS on solid-state drives Solaris 10.10.09 U8 added user and group-level ZFS quotas, ZFS cache devices and NSS_LDAP shadow account support, improvements to patching performance Solaris 10 and 9/10 U9 added physical to zone migration, ZFS triple parity RAID Z and Oracle Solaris auto registration Solaris 10 and 8/11 U10 added ZFS DFS speedups and new features, Oracle database optimization, faster reboot on SPARC system Solaris 10 and a 13th U11. See release notes 11 Express 201011-511 November 15, 2010. November 2024 Post-Oracle Closed Source adds new packaging system IPS, image packaging system and associated tools, ZFS only for boot, 1. Including IPMP, Professor TPD and enhancements, zones, immutable read-only zones, NFS servers in zones, delegated administration, P2V pre-flight check, the Zonostat utility coupled with the LibZonestat dynamically linked library, security, root as a role, netcat and enhancements, storage, ZFS shadow migration, ZFS backup, restore with NDMP, recursive ZFS send, hardware support, SPARC T4, critical threads, SDP enabled and optimized, including support for zones, senior IOV, Intel AVX, UEFI boot support Solaris 111 onwards on x86 UltraSPARC 2, 3, IV series support removed, IA32 architecture support removed 111,511 October 3, 2012 November 2024 Post-Oracle closed source new features and enhancements, installer enhancements. Service management facility configuration improvements zone improvements address space layout randomization per file authorization to edit administrative files using FEDIT command 112,511 April 29, 2014 November 2024 Post-Oracle closed source new features and enhancements, integrated hypervisor kernel zones full OpenStack distribution automation of software patches and updates, and other packaging improvements software-defined networking 113,511 October. Ago. Development release The underlying Solaris codebase has been under continuous development since work began in the late 1980s on what was eventually released as Solaris 20. Each version, such as Solaris 10, is based on a snapshot of this development codebase, taken near the time of its release, which is then maintained as a derived project. Updates to that project are built and delivered several times a year until the next official release comes out. The Solaris version under development by Sun since the release of Solaris 10 in 2005 was codenamed Nevada, and is derived from what is now the OpenSolaris codebase in 2003. An addition to the Solaris development process was initiated under the program name Software Express for Solaris or just Solaris Express. A binary release based on the current development basis was made available for download on a monthly basis, allowing anyone to try out new features and test the quality and stability of the OS as it progressed to the release of the next official Solaris version. A later change to this program introduced a quarterly release model with support available, renamed Solaris Express Developer Edition SXDE in 2007. Sun announced Project Indiana with several goals, including providing an open-source binary distribution of the OpenSolaris project, replacing SXDE. The first release of this distribution was OpenSolaris 200805. The Solaris Express Community Edition SXCE was intended specifically for OpenSolaris developers. It was updated every 2 weeks until it was discontinued in January 2010, with a recommendation that users migrate to the OpenSolaris distribution, although the download license seen when downloading the image files indicates its use is limited to personal, educational, and evaluation purposes. The license acceptance form displayed when the user actually installs from these images lists additional uses, including commercial and production environments. SXCE releases terminated with build 130 and OpenSolaris releases terminated with build 134 a few weeks later. The next release of OpenSolaris based on build 134 was due in March 2010, but it was never fully released, though the packages were made available on the package repository instead. Oracle renamed the binary distribution Solaris 11 Express, changed the license terms, and released build 151A as 201011 in November 2010. Open source derivatives currency also, OpenSolaris section. Open Indiana, a project under the Illumos umbrella aiming Wine called Midoris that can install and run Windows programs at native speed. JARIS stands for Japanese Solaris. Midoris is a combination of the Japanese word for Windows, Mado, and Solaris NAPIT, a web-managed ZFS storage appliance based on Solaris and the free forks like Omnios with a free and pro edition OpenSX, an OpenSolaris distribution release for both 32-bit and 64-bit x86 platforms and SPARC microprocessors, initially produced from OpenSolaris source code repository. repository, ported to the Illumos source code repository to form OpenIndiana's first Spark distribution, notably, the first OpenSolaris distribution with Illumos source for Spark based upon OpenIndiana. OpenSX finally moved to a new source code repository, based upon Dilos, where new releases continue Nexentaster, optimized for storage workloads, based on Nexenta OS Dyson, Illumos kernel with new userland and packages from Debian strives to become an official Debian port SmartOS, virtualization center derivative from joint discontinued OpenSolaris, a project initiated by Sun Microsystems, discontinued after the acquisition by Oracle. Nexenta OS discontinued October 31, 2012 first distribution based on Ubuntu userland with Solaris-derived kernel StormOS discontinued September 14, 2012 a lightweight desktop OS based on Nexenta OS and XFCEC also Sun Management Center Oracle VM Server for Spark Trusted Solaris OpenSolaris Illumos References Carrot Oracle announces availability of Oracle Solaris 113 October 26, 2015 retrieved October 28, 2015. Contest. Carrot source code for open source software components. Oracle Corporation website. Oracle Corporation retrieved March 4, 2013. Said Tony Imes, an analyst at Port Chester, NY, research company D.H. Brown & Associates, Solaris has earned its reputation over a long period of time. Imes said, they have been working on high-end scalability features for 10 years, and that's the only way you can get solid results. OpenSolaris project. Carrot Open CSW package list. Open CSW retrieved November 24, 2014. Carrot Oracle Technology Network developer license terms for Oracle Solaris, Oracle Solaris Cluster and Oracle Solaris Express. Oracle Corporation July 13, 2011 retrieved July 17, 2013. Carrot Solaris 26 OCF Solaris history. Carrot Solaris 10.10.09 What's New? Sun Microsystems retrieved October 9, 2009. Carrot Announcing Oracle Solaris 111 Oracle Corporation April 18, 2013 retrieved April 18, 2013. Carrot Sunos. Carrot Blastwave Open Source Sun Software September 20, 2006 archived from the original on September 20, 2006.